who scored 81 points in one single game. It's Kobe the Mamba Bryant. Light up a joint and shout out his name. It's Kobe the Mamba Bryant. Game winning trees, the king of the bank. It's Kobe the Mamba Bryant. Gold like me teeth, purple like me drank. It's Kobe the Mamba Bryant. People may say that the Lakers now suck, but he got 5 rings, so
all
we
right,
don't give
very
up.
Good, very good. Off you go.
Working hard, badly working.
Excuse me, everybody. If I may have everybody's attention, it is time for the gift-giving ceremony.
From House 76ers and the people of Philadelphia, Your Grace, it is my honor to present you with this autographed Lower Merion jersey.
Oh, wonderful. Thank you. Just throw it over there with the others.
Could you please shoo them away? The stench is unbearable.
Thank you. You may now go.
Ugh, here we go. A teddy bear.
A clutch doll for your youngest daughter, Your Grace. But feel free to use it to help you sleep at night. I hear it can be scary growing old and irrelevant.
Well, I think it's lovely, Dwight, and remarkably soft. In fact, this must be the softest thing in all the land. A wonderful memento to remember you by.
Hear ye, hear ye. His Ernest Jordan has arrived. Oh.
How lovely for Michael to show up.
His Airness apologizes he cannot attend your retirement celebration. He has a message for the Mamba. Kobe, I was like an older brother to you. Please enjoy this commemorative bubbling doll.
It's lovely. Thank you. Ah, Shaq of Neil. Good to see you, old friend.
Likewise. I'll bring you the finest donkey from all the land. Please, have your chefs prepare it, and do let me know how my ass tastes.
And now, the ceremonial passing of the torch to the next great Laker.
Clarkson, you have no chance. I think it might be Randall. It's gonna be D'Angelo.
I would miss Larry Nance.
It's not gonna be D'Angelo. He sends inappropriate ravens.
What if it's a draft?
Maybe it's like Wiggins or someone on another team.
I don't think he's passing to anyone.
I think you're right. He's refusing a pass.
He's refusing a pass.
He's refusing a pass.
Just get the rebound.
Status. Welcome back to another episode of Lakeshow's Finest Redux. I'm your host, Charles Ryan, KB24 status, Kobe24 MP3, or simply yours truly, the biggest Lakers fan in the world. And the Lakers off to a sexy 23-3 record right now. We defeated the Heat 113-110 on this beautiful Friday night. And let me tell you, that was a hell of a game. And thank you, KCP, for being a dumbass at the down the stretch and missing those free throws, making the game more tense than it needed to be. But whatever. A W is a W. Weird game, a little bit, certain point of views. LeBron had 7 turnovers tonight in the first half. I mean, he had like 7 turnovers through the first quarter in like 3 minutes. I've never seen that ever. He finished with 8 turnovers. I mean, he could have had a quadruple-double with turnovers. He almost made it. But LeBron, besides the turnovers, played well. 28 points on 50% shooting. 4-for-8 from 3. 9 rebounds, 12 assists, and a steal. He was 2-for-4 from the 3-point line, though. 2-for-4 from the 5th line. Gotta do better than that, my boy, LeBron. AD, my fantasy player, at 33 points. Also shot 11-for-20 from the field. So, 11 for 22, but a little bit better. 4-for-9 from 3. Shot 9 threes. I like it. 7-for-9 from the free throw line. 10 rebounds, 1 assist, 1 turnover, and 3 sexy blocks. But this game was a doozy to watch. I mean, Jimmy had Butler at 23 points, 3 assists, 3 rebounds, 4 steals. Nobody else really played that much better. I mean, Kendrick Nunn had 16 points, Derrick Jones Jr. had 17 points, Kelly Olynyk had 15 points. My fantasy guy, Duncan Robinson, only had 9 points. But weird game. I mean, the second quarter was huge. I mean, the third quarter, we almost had 40 points. The third quarter, we had 26 points in the third quarter when there was like 5 minutes left. So I thought there was a real shot we could actually score like 45 to 50 points in the quarter. I thought that would have been hilarious. But good comeback. We were down the first half, regrouped, came back. We had an 11-0 run at the point, and we rebounded them 36-29. Somehow we had 19 turnovers, half of those obviously attributed to LeBron James. But if we can cut down those turnovers, not miss silly free throws, we were 15-for-23 from the free throw line. If we can make that 20-for-23, that'd be much better. I mean, their free throws. But yeah. Sorry, we out-rebounded them, 50-34, actually. On KCP's final free throws, not the final ones, but the second to last set of free throws when we got that offensive rebound back to KCP, you know, that just showed how physical we were down low, blocking out, getting those rebounds. Gotta get a lot of props to Dwight. He had, I want to say Dwight had at least 10 rebounds, maybe a little bit less, but Dwight actually had 8 rebounds in 18 minutes, so that's pretty solid. Dwight knows his position, but this is a good road trip so far. I mean, our last road trip, Denver, Utah, and Portland, I believe it was, that was quite a road trip, 3-0, but so far, we are 2-0. We defeated the Magic and the Heat. We have 3 more teams to play. We play the Hawks on Sunday, Pacers Tuesday, and then Bucks on Thursday. That's a big game versus the Bucks. Potentially, we both got the same record in that game at 25-3, and that would be a who wants it, who wants to have the best record in the league game. That would be quite a competitive game. I think going 5-0 on this road trip is feasible, but if not, 4-1 would be fine. I mean, the Hawks on Sunday, there's no reason we should lose that game. I thought tonight's game was going to be a trap game. I really did. I thought there was a good chance we'd actually lose it. I'm happy I was proved wrong, but it was definitely competitive. This wasn't like the Magic game or a blowout. But so yeah, the Hawks and then the Pacers on Tuesday. I think it's a little bit tracking, like I said, but yeah, and then the Bucks, that'll be a hell of a game. But this stretch of all these road games, I mean, we're better on the road than we are at home. I think we actually have, I think we've actually played more road games so far, but our record at home is 10-2 versus on the road 13-1. So, and really, I mean, technically it's 13-0 because we lost at the Clippers, so you could count that as a home loss if you really wanted to and say we're 13-0, but we're better on the road than we are at home. That's awesome. I mean, it's one of the best starts in Lakers history, 23-3. I mean, we are a third of the way through playing 26 games, and you know, if the Lakers went 500, so there's 26 games they played, if they go 28-28 in their final 56 games, that would be over 50 wins still. That'd be 51 wins. So they really put themselves in a good position here. And I know a lot of people saying, you know, the strength of schedule in the beginning was kind of easy, but you know, there were teams that we did not expect to be good that were good, like the Mavericks. Played them twice, we lost them once. All these road games are really, really fucking difficult. I mean, I don't understand how we have like 3 or 4 road trips of like 4 games in a row away or 5 games away in a row. Like, I don't understand. Like, there's some teams that don't even have 5 games plus road trips. So I guess we get fucked there. I don't know if it's the Grammy, because the Grammys happen in the Staples Center. I don't know if that's what it is or some shit. They need to send us away. But right now, 23-3, 9-1 in our last 10 games, a 6-game winning streak. The Bucks are a 16-game winning streak, so we're going to end that in a few days. But yeah, I mean, this game was crazy. I don't know how we pulled it out of our ass, but I loved the contributions from Bradley. He's looking like himself. KCB should be benched the rest of his life because of his goddamn free throws. But, you know, good all-around effort, but a weird game. Weird game. Okay, so we're going to transition to a Lakers story time. For those who are not aware or who have not followed my podcast, like last season, I do Lakers story time every once in a while where I talk about, you know, unique events that have happened between me and the Lakers. Like, for example, I coached at Derek Fisher Basketball Academy. He has a camp every summer, and I coached there. That's like a little thing that I've done. It's kind of a Laker thing. There's other things where, like, I met Luke Walton, met Kobe, met all these players, and I tell stories about that. But this is, you know, somewhere along those lines. But so my Lakers story time is when I went to a Lakers-Mavs game last year, when it was on Halloween. The Lakers played the Mavs last year, and at the game, all the cheerleaders were dressed in costumes, a couple really hot cheerleaders and some slutty nurses. That was a cool atmosphere. A lot of weird costumes, some girls in bunny rabbit costumes. I did not wear a costume. I was kind of lame. However, you know, at the post game, you could see JaVale McGee, who was dressed as the Grinch. I think Lonzo was Batman the day before, some shit for Halloween. But that was kind of cool atmosphere. That was not really much of a story time. That's just saying a game I went to. But the actual story time is when I've told times that I met Luke Walton before, but this is a different time. So one time I went to this thing called Fiesta Lakers, where the Lakers have this event at the convention center in downtown LA. And what it is for like the ESPN Deportes and all the Latino fans. They just have this whole event, and Luke Walton was there, and like he was there with his friends, Devin George and Kareem Rush, and I am friends with the family who runs the ESPN Deportes radio station network. I think it's like 1330 Lakers, some bullshit, AM, PM, whatever. Because I was friends with the guy who ran that, I went to go meet Luke Walton privately with his friends outside of the convention center, and he was smoking cigarettes, and I thought that was hilarious, because I didn't expect NBA players to be smoking cigarettes, you know. But something that's funny that happened was my friend wanted me to take a picture of him with Luke Walton on his phone, and I was like 10 years old. And I didn't know what the hell I was doing, and I think I took the picture. I don't know if I did, and I don't think I did take the picture, and I lied, and I said I took it, so I felt bad, but I'm kind of stupid there. But Luke was really chill, nice guy. Fortunately, obviously, he's not the coach anymore, but that was weird seeing him smoking cigarettes when it's just so bad for you as a professional athlete and all that. But weird event. Noche Latina, Lakers fiesta. But yeah, so that's a story time. Not too much there, but I just thought it was funny. My interactions with Luke. I was actually there also with my two sisters, and Luke was pretty touchy around them. Yeah, gotta be honest. But yeah, so once again, Lakers, next game, versus the Hawks, Trae Young. Can't lose. If we lose, I'm gonna be upset. This is not a trap game. This is a game we have to win. But literally, there's no reason why we should lose this game. I don't expect the Lakers to rest anybody. I hope Kyle Kuzma comes back. I hope Rondo plays better. Rondo only had like 0 points tonight and like 4 assists, 2 turnovers. So need more from him. But we should win that game. Once again, I'm Charles Ryan, KB24 status, Kobe24 MP3. Or yours truly, the biggest Lakers fan in the world. Thanks again for listening. Once again, I'm sorry that I did not post the past few games. Been pretty busy, but never leave you guys behind. All right, so thanks again. Have a good one. Let's go Lakers. Peace.
Lofted it to the sky, and it dropped through a foul on Fortson.
It's phenomenal. One-on-one player. Keon Clark didn't have a clue, and it just floated hot.
Here comes Kobe for his 32nd point. A reverse slam dunk with both hands. That's one under his career high, 32 points. 8 seconds left.
Well, the chips are falling into place.
Mavericks helping the Warriors tonight. See if the Warriors can help themselves. Kobe Bryant's first field goal comes with a 180 flip off glass. His first field goal was spectacular.
Ball in, maybe it is. Harper looked for it, intercepted it, gives the ball off, and Kobe does a trick turn and
score. That got the people up out of their seats.
Well, Harper had an easy dribble drive alone from 20 feet. Jack Nicholson liked that one. Doesn't get any better than that, Jack.
Open for three, but takes it into the lane for an emphatic slam.
He closes out on the left hand, and Kobe takes it right with his strong hand to the basket.
Around his hand, and Jack finishes it off.
First slam dunk, a 360 turn in the air.
I thought he was going to be too far into the basket, but
he did too.
He converted it.
He's underneath, slam dunk, basket counts. What a great finish. You talk about a guy that's grown from a boy to a man in about 2 weeks.
Kobe's got it, spin it up and in.
He hangs, throws it up, gets to contact, and gets the crowd a little excited.
Do you believe that?
That was one of the greatest plays I've ever seen.